welcome back to my channel. So it's been a long time. So today I'm going to be doing a tutorial on this look that I'm wearing right here, which I actually filmed a couple of months ago. And basically I ended up losing the footage and then everything got really crazy for me all at once. I got super duper busy. For those of you who don't know, I am in school. I'm a student. So it was like towards the end of the semester. So I had so much work to do and then finals. And then I'm actually moving in 4 days, so this will be the last time you see me filming in this setup. So then I was like apartment searching and hunting and getting everything figured out with that, buying furniture, packing stuff up. So I finally have had a minute to sit down and chill, and I'm using that time to film, of course, because I did really, really like this look when I filmed it, and although I did lose the footage, I wanted to definitely film it again because I love it so much. When I filmed it a couple months ago, it was initially intended to be like a fall makeup look. Obviously, fall is long gone by now, but I still think this look is like really perfect for anything. It's perfect for going out, it's perfect to wear to work, to the grocery store. I just love it so much, and I love like the dramatic ombre eye with the bold lip. Of course, you can switch out the lip if you want to do something a little bit more natural and make it more daytime appropriate, but at the time I was going for a fall vibe, hence the dark lip. But I do really, really like this combination, so yeah. Also, side note, I'm thinking about my next video when I move into my new apartment, filming sort of like a chit-chat, get ready with me life update sort of thing, so I can talk to you guys basically about what's going on and why I'm so busy and why I'm moving. And I do have like a look that I've been wearing a lot recently that I want to film, but it's not anything that exciting, so I figured if I did it as like a get ready with me style, you guys can still see how to get the look, but it won't be like a boring kind of tutorial because I'll be talking to you guys about what's going on with me. So I think that's the next video that I'm going to do in my new setup in my new house, which I have no idea how I'm even going to set that up or where I'm going to film yet, but I'll figure all that out. But just let me know if you guys want to see that, because that's probably the next video I will film, because this is probably going to be a quick just boom 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 step after step tutorial. So anyways, yeah, let me know what you guys think, but that's it. I will stop rambling for now. Thank you guys so much for tuning in today. I am so glad to be back finally with a tutorial for you guys. If you guys want to see how to get this smoky ombre eye with a bold chocolatey lip, then just keep on watching.
So I'm actually going to be starting out with my eyebrows today, which is something that I haven't done on camera yet, but I've been doing pretty regularly for the past few months. And for this, I'm going to be using the Anastasia Dip Brow, and I believe I'm using the shade medium in this video. So I just start out by combing them with a spoolie, and then I'm taking this little angled brush by Real Techniques, and then filling in the tail starting on the top where it looks a little sparse, and then creating the line at the bottom through the front, and then just flicking it gently upward through the front of the brow to create little hair-like strokes, and then combing it back out with a spoolie just to make sure everything is nice and blended together. Then I'm going to underline my brows with the Zoeva Brow Line brush and the Tarte Shape Tape Concealer in the shade Fair. I've been doing this differently recently too, and I really, really like the way this looks. It gives a really nice lift to the brow and creates like that natural brow bone highlight, and also helps carve out your brows and shape them so you can clean up if you made any mistakes filling them in. Then I'm going to take that same concealer, and I'm just going to use the wand this time, and I'm just going to dab a little bit of that on my eyelids, and I'm going to use this as an eyeshadow primer. Using concealer is actually my favorite way to prime my eyelids. It's what I always use. I just think it works the best for me personally. So once I have that base down, I'm just going to go ahead and blend it out with my beauty blender, and then I am going to set it with a translucent powder. Then for my base shade, as always, I am using the NYX eyeshadow in Kiss the Day and just packing that all over my lids to set the concealer down really, really well and make sure everything is nice in one color. And having that lid color down will also help me blend out my eyeshadow easier much later. Then I'm just going to take some Scotch tape, and you guys have seen me do this technique here before on my channel, but I'm just going to take it first and I'm going to put it on the back of my hand and rip it off just so it's not quite as sticky, so when I go to take it off of my eyes, it doesn't pull at my skin too much. But this technique is just my favorite way to make sure I have a nice, sharp, clean, crisp line, you know, if that's the kind of look that I'm going for, which I am in this case. And then for my first eyeshadow color, I am going to take the Anastasia eyeshadow in this shade Birkin, which is just a really pretty kind of pink undertoned brown. It's very, very fair. And I'm taking this on a NYX blending brush. And I'm just going to buff that all up in the upper part of my crease, back and forth, all the way from outer corner to inner corner as my first transition shade. And to deepen up the crease a little bit more, I'm taking the color Blazing, also by Anastasia. This is much deeper and a little bit more of a reddish orangey shade. I'm taking this on my Zoeva blending brush. I can never remember the name of this brush, but I'll link it below. It's hands down my favorite blending brush I've ever used. And I'm going to do basically the same thing with this shade that I did with the Birkin. But this time I'm going to concentrate a little bit more of that color first in the outermost corner of my eye, and then once there's a little bit of less product on the brush, I'm going to start to buff that across the crease. And I'm really going to make sure I take my time with this shade, really blending it out so it's nice and seamless, and building up the color little by little so it's not too intense right away. And then I'm just going to take a smaller, more dense blending brush. This is also by Zoeva, and this is another one of my absolute favorites. Again, don't remember the name, so I'll link it down below. But I'm just taking the exact same shade on this brush just to help build up the color a little bit more. This will pack on more color by using a smaller brush and help me get a little bit more precision, because as you can see here, I'm really focusing that color right into my crease, not really above it, just right in the outer corner and crease of my eye. And then, as I always do, I'm going back in with those two fluffier brushes that I used before just to blend everything back out and make sure there are no harsh lines, because you know we don't fuck with harsh lines in the makeup world unless you're doing a cut crease, you know, different story. Anyways, then I'm going to take the color Shimma Shimma by Makeup Geek, and this is a really pretty super pale pink shade, and I'm going to start to create that ombre effect by packing this right in the inner corner and the very innermost third of my eye. And then I'm going to take Anastasia's Glisten eyeshadow, which is a little bit of a deeper pink. I'm going to use that to put that right in the center portion of my lid. And for this color, I did have to spray it with a little bit of Fix Plus to get it to perform the way I wanted to. So I just sprayed my MAC 242 brush with some Fix Plus and put it on my lid. And then I went back in with the Shimma Shimma just to re-intensify the color on the inner corner. Then I'm going in with Makeup Geek eyeshadow in the shade Showtime, and this is one of their foiled eyeshadows. And I'm taking this on a little tiny pencil brush, also by Zoeva, and I'm starting to pack that on the outer third of my eye, really in that outer V, and this is when the ombre effect really starts to come into play. And then after I have that set down, I'm going back in with the shade that I used directly on my lid and packing that back on to help blend together the outer corner color and the middle of the lid shade. Then I'm going in with Makeup Geek, what is it called? Bitten eyeshadow, that's the one. It's this really pretty cranberry shade, and I'm taking that on the same Zoeva blending brush that I used before, and I'm just going to start to place that into the crease to help fuse together the crease shades with that kind of cranberry color on the outer corner of the eye. And I'm going back in with my larger blending brushes that I used before once again, just to buff out those lines a little bit. And then here, you'll see me just kind of go back over some of the lid shades and the outer corner shade just until I feel like they're all blended together and all have the desired pigmentation, because sometimes when you're blending, they can kind of get blended away in a sense. So you want to make sure you kind of bring back the pigmentation and blend it back out just kind of until you get it to where you are satisfied with the way that it looks. So then I'm going to peel off that tape to reveal a nice, crisp, clean, sharp, beautiful line. And then I'm just taking a Q-tip to kind of clean that up a little bit just to help buff it out so it's not so, so harsh and sharp, just to soften it a tiny bit. And then I'm just quickly highlighting my brow bone using that same Shimma Shimma shade that I used in my inner corner and inner third of my eyelid. Then I'm going to start on the rest of my face. So I'm first going to be priming my skin with the Becca Backlight Priming Filter. And this just gives a really beautiful illuminating glow to the skin. So I'm putting this all over the face. And then, as always, I'm taking a smoothing primer. This is the Benefit Professional, my absolute fave. And I'm just placing this where I have the most visible pores and texture, which is on my nose and like underneath my eyes and in the center of my forehead. Then for foundation today, I'm going to be using the Hourglass Vanish Foundation Stick. This is one of my new favorites. And as you can see, this color is darker than my face, but matches my neck as per usual. And yes, I am using a lot of this stuff. It does have pretty good coverage. I would say it's like a medium to full buildable coverage foundation, One thing I have noticed about it is that it does look really, really good when you first put it on, but it doesn't wear the best throughout the day. So if you're looking for a really long wearing foundation, this probably isn't the one for you, but it does have a beautiful finish for like the first like 5 or so hours. But anyways, then I'm just going to buff that out with this Juvia's Place brush. This is from a limited edition brush set. I'm so sorry, you guys. I should have used a different foundation brush. I have a million other ones that I love, but this has just honestly been my favorite recently, especially for this foundation. They are a match made in heaven. And then I'm just going in with this Real Techniques Diamond Sponge Blender thingy. This is something that I always do. Even when I use a brush for my foundation, I always go back in, whether it be with a beauty blender or just any beauty sponge, to help kind of buff it out and soak up the excess product, because this is just what makes it look the most flawless, in my opinion. And then I'm doing some color correcting as usual. My dark circles are a huge problem for me, so this is something that I always do. And for this today, I'm using the Smashbox Color Correcting Stick in Look Less Tired, which is a really dark orange shade, and just putting a shit ton of that under my eyes, and then going over it with my Kevin Aucoin Sensual Skin Enhancer in the shade number 8 with my Morphe E8 brush to kind of help conceal it as best as I can. And then to help further conceal and also to highlight, I am taking the Tarte Shape Tape Concealer in the shade Light Medium, I believe is what I used in this video. And this concealer, you guys, is my obsession. Putting in a triangle shape under my eyes as per usual. And then I'm adding a little bit of the shade, I think it's Light Sand, just to lighten it up a little bit, because I do like a pretty bright under eye highlight, and the shade that I was using wasn't quite light enough. Then I'm just blending that out with my beauty blender as always, and blending the excess product onto my nose, chin, and forehead, because I like to balance out that under eye highlight, but I do not like to put any additional excess product in those areas because I don't want it to look too heavy or cakey. Then I'm just setting it with my RCMA No Color Powder, as always my favorite under eye setting powder of my entire life. Then, as I always do, I'm just putting a little bit of a yellow powder under my eyes to help brighten them up further, and I'm using the Marc Jacobs one for this, and I'm also putting that in all the other places where I highlighted. And then I'm going to highlight my face, and for this I am using the Anastasia So Hollywood Illuminator, and I've been doing this kind of right after my foundation recently because I find that it looks so much better when my skin is still a little bit tacky from like the wet foundation. The highlight sticks to it so much better and is so more poppin'. I mean, just look at that, like, damn, that is blinding as fuck. Then I'm going in with another highlight because you already know one is never enough. This is Laura Geller Peach Glow, and I'm putting that just on the cheekbones to kind of tie in with the pink tones that I've got going on my eyes. Then I'm going to start to work on my lower lash line, and for this I'm going to use the ColourPop gel liner, not gel liner, a little pencil liner in the shade Best O, and this is a really beautiful kind of deep purple cranberry shade, and I'm just lining my inner waterline with that. And then I'm going to take the Makeup Geek foiled eyeshadow in the shade Showtime on the same little pencil brush that I was using before, and I'm going to use that to buff out that shade on the lower lash line. I'm just working that all the way from the outer corner to like the middle part of my eye and stopping there, not bringing it all the way across because I want to leave that inside corner open just like it is on the top of my eye. And then I'm just popping in that Makeup Geek Shimma Shimma shade right in there. And then I'm going to just give my eyelashes a curl, and then I'm going to apply some mascara. And I'm using my favorite mascara. This is the Tarte, what is it, Tartist? I guess the Tartist mascara. It's the black and gold one. Hands down favorite mascara I've ever used. And then I'm going to put on some falsies. These are the Ardell lashes in the number 601. And honestly, guys, these lashes look really pretty and really fun because they're really spiky and long, but they performed, they were a bitch to put on, let me just say that. The lash band was not workable at all, so they were really uncomfortable to use and to wear, but they are really pretty, so I wouldn't recommend this exact style if I'm being completely honest, because this shit was not easy. Anyways, then I'm going to finish up my face, and I'm going to bronze using the Maybelline Fit Me powder in the shade 240. My favorite bronzing powder ever, you guys already know. And I'm using my Benefit Hoola brush, which, oh my god, it's so cute. Look at it. The stick, or the handle, I guess you want to call it, is like a little bamboo stick. How cute is that? Anyways, then I'm going to contour my face using the same Marc Jacobs duo that I used to highlight earlier, but this time I'm using the contour shade on my e.l.f. contour brush. This is my current favorite contour brush. It just works so good. You just put a little bit on, blend it out, boom, you're done. And it cuts the cheekbones, let me tell you. And then to contour my forehead, this is my favorite brush for that. This is the Real Techniques. I think it's the 300 brush from the Bold Metals collection. It just fits boop, boop, boop right in there perfectly. Then I'm adding some Becca Wild Honey Blush. It doesn't really have a whole lot of color to it. It's nice and natural and bronzy because I want to keep most of the attention on the eyes and the lips since those are really bold. Then I'm going to line my lips using the NYX lip liner in the shade Club Hopper. And I thought it was going to turn out a lot more brown. This is my first time using it, but it showed up really purple. But it's okay, whatever, because the lipstick went over it and it didn't really matter in the end. But then I'm using the Ofra lipstick in the shade Brooklyn, this beautiful, deep, chocolatey brown lip. And the formula of these Ofra liquid lipsticks, you guys, is so comfortable. Hands down, my favorite lipstick liquid lipstick. Oh my god, I'm all over the place. Liquid lipstick formula that I have tried ever. It's really, really bomb. Then I'm going to spritz my face with the Pixie Hydrating Milky Mist to give my face a nice radiant glow and to help fuse all the powders together with my skin. And after that is complete, you are done with this hot mess of a makeup tutorial. Thank you guys so much for bearing with me today and watching this video. I really hope you enjoyed, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.